It looks like we have a new project. This enormous radio control Pilatus Turbo Porter. You might recognise this famous aircraft from the films James Bond, Goldeneye and Air America. In the James Bond film, the plane is made famous because it does a very steep, controlled, almost vertical dive. And in Air America, it's famous because of its short field takeoff and landing performance. And both of these qualities will be really useful in this type for our project. And you remember me saying a while back that our electric tow plane is a little bit small for some of our bigger glider models. Well, this could be the answer. I purchased this almost ready to fly kit in the sales, and although I don't care much for the paint scheme, we're going to put this together and make some modifications as we go.
Including adding a variable pitch, constant speed propeller, modifying the tail to make it removable for transport, and adding a glider tow hook. I have this motor and speed controller left over from a previous project. And this speed controller has a governor mode on it, which is important for this constant speed propeller project. We will need to replace this solid metal shaft though from the motor with this one, which is hollow, from a T-Rex 500 helicopter. And then once again, my friend Mark to the rescue with his metalwork lathe and milling machine. From this sketch that we arrived at, we came up with this solution. This hub is machined from aluminium, and on the edges are 3mm holes around which a T-Rex 450 blade grip will rotate, and these will hold our propeller blades. Then, this second, smaller disc will be fastened to a rod which moves in and out inside the motor shaft, and that will control the blade pitch. Let's start by disassembling the motor in order to replace the shaft. I found one grub screw that was really difficult to remove as it had been done up really tight and secured with permanent red thread lock. In the end, I had to drill it out. I really hope that all this effort will be worth it. But remember, the full size is powered by a PT-6 turboprop. So that's a jet engine that turns a large variable pitch propeller. And that's what gives the aircraft this amazing performance. Hopefully, this large brushless motor running at constant RPM on a governor will sound quite realistic too. These three bolts that I'm undoing pass through the radial bearings in each of the T-Rex 450 blade grips. They thread right through the hub boss and tighten down onto the motor shaft, securing the propeller in position. And here we have the new hollow motor shaft installed, ready to fit the motor into the aeroplane. To do this, I'm going to make our own mount, and I'm starting with this drawing I'm doing in Inkscape using simple shapes. I'm making good use of the align and distribute tools and also the path, add and subtract functions to get to our final shape.
Welcome back to my workshop. Please excuse the mess, as usual, there's lots of jobs going on all at once. Here are our cut parts, quite flexible in this thin plywood, but we're going to now laminate all four of these parts together with slow curing epoxy, which will make them super tough, and we'll also laminate them with carbon fibre while we're at it. I took the trouble while I was laser cutting these parts to cut one out of clear acrylic as a template so we can accurately mark the firewall. And I'll have to carefully position the template so that we avoid the stringers on the inside for the claw nuts.
I glued together and laid all these bits up between two sheets of glass with weights on top while the epoxy cures overnight. Now let's drill some holes in the firewall and fit some claw nuts for our standoffs. I'm using a bolt and washer to draw the teeth of the claw nuts into the back of the firewall. I'm making some standoffs for the mounting plate from this M6 steel threaded rod and some aluminium tubing. These standoff components are glued together using JB Weld, which is a special epoxy for gluing metals. We must clean out the excess from the threads with a rag soaked in isopropyl alcohol. The propeller pitch servo will fit in this bay, and it will move a bearing and collet assembly on this rod.
With the motor and propeller assembly all installed, I figured we could use some more access into the motor bay. So I've decided to take the cowl and cut it like this, so it comes off in two bits. And in fact, I'll put a little bit of wood or something in here for a rebate to the top to fit against, and a further block and two screws, and perhaps two screws, so it's nice and secure. But now we have access to the back of that propeller boss that the spinner can fasten to. And obviously all this has to come apart yet and be reassembled with threadlock when we're ready, but at least it gives us an idea. And finally, I've decided to make something with a bearing in that supports this motor shaft back here. This shot should clearly demonstrate why we're choosing to make the tailplane removable, as now we've added the motor and cowl in, it's getting quite long, although it is very light for its size.
Of course, we're going to need some propeller blades, and so I used this diagram that I downloaded to draw out some ideas in Google SketchUp. I don't yet know whether I will 3D print the propeller blades directly, or whether to 3D print some moulds to make some carbon fibre blades. I'm going to run some test parts off our CR10 Max 3D printer. That's all we have time for in this episode. Please like and subscribe to support the channel. We'll try our very best to put the updates of this project out every Saturday, but we might just need to intersperse the project with some of our other videos just to let the build catch up. Catch you next time.